America was the last continent to be populated by humans. They entered through Beringia and they started a rapid migration southwards. They entered South America around 15,000 years ago. Not only one migration took place, but several ones, but the interaction between these migrations is still unresolved.
In this study, we used a combination of genetics, linguistics, archaeology, and history to connect the indigenous diversity of South America with the history of migration and contact in the continent. We focused on the Mapuche, the largest indigenous communities of the Southern Cone, which is the southernmost part of South America.
My name is Epifania Arango, and I'm a PhD student at the University of Zurich. We have been working on this project over the last 3 years. For this paper, we collected 64 samples coming from participants belonging to three Mapuche communities, Lafkente, Pehuente, and Huiliche from the island of Chiloé. We generated genome-wide SNP chip data, and we merged it with other available samples from contemporary populations as well as ancient data. One of the main results is that there are three main genetic clusters present in South America, the one in the central Andes, the one in the Amazonia, and the one in the southern cone where the Mapuche belong. We were also able to trace the genetic ancestor of the Mapuche communities in the southern Chile, and it traced back at least to the Middle Holocene, around 5,000 years ago. At the same time, we were able to describe different population dynamics that occurred during the Middle and Late Holocene. For example, migration that involved the genetic ancestor of the Mapuche populations into the far south, in population as Yamaná, Cabezcar, or Selnam. So we're able to describe population dynamics that were not described before. For example, a contact with the central Andes that predates the Inca Empire. So at the same time, this contact was not only genetic, but it also involved the borrowing of words, crops, and certain cultural traits. We discovered that there is a strong connection in the individuals from the island of Chiloé with a population coming from the far south. Thanks to the historical record and the conversation that we had with the participants, came to the conclusion that this must be a connection with a population called the Chono that used to live in the south of the island. So by studying indigenous history, we are understanding the indigenous roots of the continent, and like also presenting another side of history that hasn't been described enough.
It has been very crucial to work with Chilean colleagues and with an international team composed by geneticists, linguists, archaeologists, and anthropologists.
Si hay un compromiso que se hizo con las personas en una materia tan sensible como un proyecto genético y una muestra de ADN que ellos entregaron de forma anónima y de forma voluntaria, era muy justo y necesario retornar los resultados.
The study was developed with direct exchanges with the participants, as we wanted to represent the communities appropriately. We also want to develop our study in transparency. I hope this study can contribute to tell an important chapter in South American history and to raise the attention on Mapuche culture, history, and the presence today.